Hi, this is Joachim for StatisticsGlobe.com, and in this video I'll explain how to draw a composition of plots using the patchwork package in the R programming language. In this video I'm going to show you several examples, and all of these examples are based on the data frame that we can create with lines 2 to 7 of the code. So if you run these lines of code, you will see that at the top right of RStudio, a new data frame object appears, which is called data. And we can also have a look at this data frame by clicking on the data object. And then a new window appears, which is showing the structure of our data. So in this case, our data frame contains three columns, X, Y, and a grouping column, which is consisting of four different factor levels. Now, let's assume that we want to draw these data in different types of plots using the ggplot2 package. Then we need to install and load the ggplot2 package, as you can see in lines 9 and 10 of the code. I have installed the package already, so I'm just going to load it with line 10 of the code. And after running this line of code, we are able to use the functions of the ggplot2 package. In the following lines of code, I'm going to create three different plots based on our data frame. So first, I'm going to create a scatter plot with lines 12 to 14 of the code. So if you run these lines of code, you will see that at the top right of RStudio, a new plot object appears, which is called ggp1. And you can see at the bottom right of RStudio that our plot is a scatter plot where the different groups of our data are represented by different colors. Now in lines 16 to 18 of the code, I'm going to draw a line plot. And in lines 20 to 22, I'm going to draw a bar plot. Now, if we want to draw these three plots in a grid of plots, we can use the patchwork package. And if we want to use the patchwork package, we first need to install and load the package. As you can see in lines 24 and 25 of the code, I have installed this package as well. So I'm just going to load it with line 25 of the code. And after running this line of code, we are able to use the functions of the patchwork package. So the simplest way of using the patchwork package is when we just want to draw our plots side by side in the same row. Then we can simply add our plots together, as you can see in line 27 of the code. So if we run this line of code, you will see that a new plot object appears at the top right of RStudio, which is called ggpcombi1. And we can also draw this plot to RStudio by running line 28 of the code. And then you can see at the bottom right that we have created a new graphic, which is consisting of the three plots that we have created before. In this composition of plots, you can also see that all the plots are shown side by side, so in the same row of our grid of plots. However, the patchwork package allows us to create grids of plots with multiple rows by simply using a slash, as you can see in line 30 of the code. So if you run this line of code, a new plot object appears at the top right, and we can also draw this new plot to RStudio by running line 31 of the code. And then you can see at the bottom right of RStudio that we have created another composition of plots, and this time our plot composition has two rows. You can also see that on the left side, in the first column of our plot composition, there's only one plot shown, and this is because in line 30 of the code, we have specified only one plot in front of the plus sign. However, after the plus sign, we have specified two plots separated by a slash, and for that reason, in the second column of our plot composition, two plots are shown. So another possibility that is provided by the patchwork package is that we use parentheses to specify the columns and rows of our plot composition in some more detail. And this is what I'm showing you in line 33 of the code. So in this line of code, I'm specifying that the first row of our plot composition should contain only the first plot. And then in the second row, I'm specifying that I want to show our second and third plot. So if you run line 33 and 34 of the code, you will see that a new plot composition is created at the bottom right of RStudio. And this time we have specified only one plot in the first row and two plots in the second row. So in this video, you have learned how to draw different plot compositions using the patchwork package in the R programming language. However, in case you want to learn more on this topic, you could check out my homepage, statisticsglobe.com, because on the homepage I have recently published a tutorial in which I'm explaining the content of this video in some more detail, and I will put a link to this tutorial into the description of the video. In the description of the video, I will also put a link to the homepage of the Patchwork package, because on this homepage you will find additional tutorials on how to use the Patchwork package in R. And I can definitely recommend to check out this homepage, because on the homepage you will find many other options that are provided by the Patchwork package. Furthermore, if you have liked the video, I would be very happy if you leave me some positive feedback in the comments or if you give me thumbs up on the video. And make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel in order to get notifications in future when I'm releasing new videos to the channel. That's it for this video. Thanks a lot. See you next time. Bye bye.